Matthew Thompson. Hello, John and Amanda. I've been watching your YouTube since James did the belt video. I loved watching Breakfast and all the videos with Mookie and Jacob. I really love the idea of you picking up the prepper banner and running with more grain mills, with more grain mills don't shit bread videos. So let me tell you something about the prepper thing. When I moved here, James was not at all into prepping. I sat for years and told James, hey, you need to get some Mountain House. Hey, you need to put some wheat away. James, you will tell James something every day until the point you just get tired of telling James something. And then a couple years will go by and James will be like, hey, I got this idea. You should do this. I'm like, yes, I told you to do this every day for a year and a half. And then James picked it up. James, you need to start a Facebook. I don't need a fucking Facebook. And then James starts a YouTube. James is like, hey, you should start a YouTube. I'm like, James, I run a company. He's like, I run it. I go, when's the last time you taught, James? You haven't taught a class in 2 years. I go, you want to make money? Do Fighting Pistol with James Yeager and charge three times for it, right? If the class is 500, it's 1500 bucks, but James is going to be in the class. James is like, well, you still need to start a YouTube channel. I'm like, James, all you do is YouTube. You have not taught a class in 2 years. And that's great. I don't have a James was making real money on YouTube. James' channel got to a million fucking viewers before they banned it, right? And you always knew it was bullshit because they would let James start a new channel. Mm-hmm. He just couldn't have his old channel back. And this is why. Everybody's like, they're against all the gun guys. They're against the gun guys. They did it to a lot of other guys, too. They didn't just do it to the gun guys. They did it to tons of other people outside the gun industry. It's because they were paying those guys under the old pay scale. And once you had a million viewers, once you had 100,000 viewers, it got to a different pay rate. Once you got a million viewers, it got to a different, they were paying these guys so much money. By killing these channels, they had to start over under the new rules, the new guidelines, and it doesn't pay the money it used to pay. They used us in the beginning to grow these platforms, and now they don't need us because everybody's addicted to the platforms. But James, it didn't start, James was not a prepper channel. James spent several years where all he did was rice and buckets and prepping and stuff. And then James went away from that. Went, you know, people were burnt out on it or whatever. And during the COVID, you saw all these prepper channels just grow. These guys had been there for years with 2,000, 5,000 followers. But during the COVID, they grew and had 50,000, 100,000. And here's what they did. They just took the news and the panic. They took the fear and built 10-minute videos about it. And if you look at most of these guys' channels right now, they're making the exact same fucking videos. They're saying the exact same shit. And it's they're more of news reporting, but they're reporting news of fear. And it's just their members going, I was downtown Idaho, Walmart, no chicken. I was in Kentucky, Louisville, Kentucky, Walmart, no chicken. And they just all saying the same shit. And when you look at it, like we watched these guys, we watched all these dudes, we'd send all of them back and forth to all of us. And then I'm like, Amanda, well, she'd send me pictures at Walmart. We'd be missing some stuff. It's never shit we used. Never, never. They're missing Cheetos. They're shit. Never shit we ate was not available.
They were out of pasta for about 6 months.
Yeah. I got 18,000 pounds of fucking pasta.
Yeah, not shit that we're eating.
And when they were out of pasta,
it was noticeable though.
Sam's Club still had pasta.
Yes.
Costco still had pasta. It was just Walmart didn't have pasta. Why is that? Let me tell you. Walmart negotiates a price, and you might not know this, but Walmart is owned by Sam's Club. Sam's, you know, the Sam's Club and Walmart, they're the same fucking company. But Walmart negotiates on such a big level. They would negotiate on an 18-month cycle. So they're not going to buy, they're not going to negotiate price on this batch. They're going to negotiate on 18 months worth of shit. So they're very, very to the bottom penny, cutting fractions of pennies in half. So when your supply lines got fucked up and the manufacturers only had so much merchandise, who are they going to default on? Who they're going to fucking fulfill the companies that are paying them the most money. And that ain't fucking Walmart. So Walmart was missing a bunch of shit, and that's why that was. So, yes, we're that's why my, and that's another part with our algorithms, right? I don't have a genre to my channel. If we just made videos about prep, if we had a channel that only did prepping videos and a channel that only did business motivation and a channel that only did homestead, those channels would all three be huge. They'd be way bigger by just like, I just don't want to do that. I make videos while we're fucking going through the day and they happen to be what you see. And the people that show up are, they're just more interested. They're more real friends, more real customers, right? They're vetted. And that's our life that you see. We are doing some videos. We're going to do several other videos with Jacob. Jacob could come in here any day and we could do podcasts about anything and they would always be good podcasts. More grain mills don't ship bread videos. I just want to thank you for all your content. Happy to give you a few dollars a month for your great content. The pulling the thread videos were some of my favorite and I'm glad to see them coming back. I hope you had a happy new year and a great 2023. Thank you. Our New Year's was great. We didn't do fucking anything.
I think we were in bed before midnight.
Always. Every New Year's Eve,
we're in bed before midnight. It's been a long time since we were up past midnight on New Year's.
Most of the time for us, we would just, like, Annie would go to bed, and I would stay up, and because I was up anyway.
I'm old,
but
man.
But this year, we got the oldest up to do big girl stuff and watch. It wasn't even the ball. I don't even know if you can get the ball anymore. I don't know if it's still a thing.
It's in New York. It's there.
Yeah, but we watched something like that. It was whatever was streaming, so she could see it change over. And then we all just went straight to bed after that.
So there's some video out there right now, short form content of dudes on New Year's Eve in Chicago. And it's a fucking war zone.
Yeah.
Like full automatic weapons firing and just a crazy, like you hear bullets hitting next to where this dude's filming.
Yeah.
Like it's close enough. You hear them hitting metal and shit. I don't know that there's a ton of fucking people just shooting fucking guns up in the air.
So, you know, like, the big thing always is, was that fireworks or was that gunshots? And, like,
this is fucking guns.
Yeah, like, you can tell the difference if you really pay attention. And that night, I was sitting there with my dog at my feet. We were just, like, I was working or something. And something sounded different about one. Like, it was like this, they were shooting. They weren't doing fireworks. Yeah. And what was odd is the dog noticed the difference too. Like he got up and was like, what was that? Even though fireworks were going off all night long, he picked that out too.
Yeah.
But I thought that was weird that like he knew, you know?
And maybe these weren't, maybe it's like one of those like binary triggers or something. I don't think I've ever been around one of those when it's shooting, but it sounded just like fucking machine guns.
Oh yeah. That's what I'm saying. Like you can tell the difference between that and fireworks.
Yeah. He says, sorry, it's been a while since I built a house. That's fucking awesome, man. Built a house. That is very cool.
So your girls might like, I haven't seen it in a long time. They used to do the Rose Parade on New Year's Day out of Pasadena.
Uh-huh.
So when I was a kid, I lived right in LA County and we would drive to Pasadena on New Year's Eve and we would sleep on the street in a sleeping bag.
Uh-huh.
With our shoes under our pillow so nobody would steal our shoes, and we would wake up with the sun and watch the Rose Parade before going home. We did that probably 8 years in a row.
I don't remember. I have a picture of it, so it's time-stamped on Facebook, but I don't remember if it was New Year's Day or not, but we did like a marathon that started at the Rose Bowl and ended at the Rose Bowl, and I think it might have been part of the parade.
Yeah, probably.
Remember. Yeah. Probably. It was pretty interesting.
Yep. So the parade, that's the Rose Day Parade?
Yeah.
And all those floats are made of rose petals, if you haven't
flowers.
Seen
flowers, yeah.
And that's where the Rose Bowl is when they have the football game, which is on the,
It's a game ball.
You have a stadium. So it's a college stadium. I forgot which team played there.
Doesn't matter.
But yeah, but the stadium is actually called the Rose Bowl.
Yep.
Isn't that the L.A. Coliseum?
It's in Pasadena.
No, it's in Pasadena.
So, yeah, it's like northeast L.A.
So they didn't have one of the Supercrosses there in the series?
I don't think so, no. Got that it. Would be like more like in L.A.
So those floats, when I was 17, I went with my aunt's Girl Scout troop. We went to, and we actually put flowers on one of the floats for the Rose
Bowl. Yeah, it's a huge thing if
it was
you ever
pretty
see
neat.
The making of those floats.
Yeah.
It's pretty neat.
All right, guys. Well, that was question and answer episode 23. Hope there's some value entertainment. More importantly, I hope there's something that makes you think in maybe a little different manner. And that was kind of the eye-opening for me, right? I was literally thinking, oh, I'm going to start doing these selling these eggs and set the little stand up and have firewood bundles. And why am I doing that, right? Why? Because I don't know why I'm doing it. I don't need the money from it. But the eggs are so expensive that was the cost I had in my head for me to deal with people. And then my excuse for that was that the feed cost twice as much. But, I mean, I hope that all of you are in some position where you don't have to do something you're not doing because something has changed. I hope that you could just have something in your life where you could spend a little bit of time and just make that money. Does your feed cost more? Does your gas cost more, right? Your gas isn't $3. It went up 50 cents. Who the fuck cares? Like, are you really in a position that $5, 50 cent gasoline matters to you, right? It's a talking point. If it really makes a difference in your life, you need to have a fucking different life. And let's figure out what that looks like for you. Most of you have something, but as soon as you say you want something and we start talking about it, you start telling me why you can't. And you lost me right the fuck there.
No more excuses.
No more excuses. So.
Sounds like a t-shirt.
Yeah, but.
No, I mean, like, it sounds like it's going to be an SOE.
Oh, t-shirt. I don't know about that.